Hey guys, welcome to episode 4 of the Social Media Manager Bible podcast. And I am so excited to discuss this topic because it's been, how will I say it? People have been talking about it, and it is how to use Chatgpt as a social media manager. Like, except if you live under the rock or under a rock or under a stone or something, you definitely know what ChatGPT is. And I feel like a lot of people have been underutilizing ChatGPT, and I'm here for you as your social media manager bestie, your social media manager mentor, to show you the ways you can use ChatGPT to improve your efficiency as a social media manager. Now, first, I'm going to start with defining what ChatGPT is. And before I actually wrote down my script, I thought, okay, I should do a walkthrough video on how to use ChatGPT. But there are a lot of walkthrough videos on the internet. Like, you can check YouTube. I'm sure there are a lot of walkthrough videos on how you can instruct ChatGPT or how you can prompt ChatGPT. But mine is to tell you how you can use it as a social media manager, because you need to use if you don't know how to use ChatGPT as a social media manager, you're going to be spending so much time and you will get lost in, how will I say it, in the well of searching and searching and searching for ideas and never implementing. Now, ChatGPT is an AI-powered language model. It was developed by OpenAI, and it can generate human-like texts based on the input it receives. So you have to give it an input. And this technology can be used in a variety of ways, but in this video, I already hear that I'm specifically going to focus on how social media managers can use it to improve their workflow, because it has helped me improve my workflow. So let's go right into it. Number one is automated responses. This is one of the most consuming, and like, it consumes your time as a social media manager. When it comes to responding to messages, responding to comments from followers, it is time consuming. But with ChatGPT, you can set up automated responses that are triggered by certain keywords. Now, you'll be asking me, but how do I use ChatGPT in Instagram? Most of the schedulers that we use right now, they have incorporated ChatGPT, OpenAI, like, into their system. So you can use it to respond to DMs. You can use it to respond to comments very fast. I don't know if I'm going to do an instructional video for that, but yeah, you can. And this can help you save significant amount of time, especially during busy periods, and allow you to focus on other tasks. Like, you don't have to spend all your time in the DMs. Now, how does this work? Number one, you need to set up a chatbot. I don't know if you know what chatbots are, but a chatbot can be used to, like, respond to specific questions or requests from your customers automatically. I know some of you have sent DMs to people and you get like a response like that looks like the person set it up and they are currently not available to answer you. That's like a chatbot doing the response for them. So there are many apps that actually use chatbots, but some of them are ManyChat. I've used ManyChat before. It works really well, so I can recommend ManyChat for you. There's Mobile Monkey. I've never tried it before, but it's recommendations from people. There's Snatchbot, and there's Taz. So you can use it, and you can use it to respond to common inquiries or common customer service requests in the DMs. And this can free up time for you because you don't have to necessarily be there in the DMs to respond. Number two, you can use predictive responses. Now, ChatGPT can help you generate predictive responses that you would impute into your chatbots. And this will help you build a better connection with your customers and also increase your customer satisfaction. So you would use predictive responses to frequently ask questions that people ask you in the DMs or the brands you're managing in the DMs. And with ChatGPT, you are able to like develop these responses, which also leads me to the third point, which is personalization. Once ChatGPT has developed these responses for you, these predictive responses for you, you can now personalize it in a way that it doesn't look like it's a robot that is communicating with them. It looks like it's you. It's Balaji that is still communicating, but she's currently not available. Not just like sounding robot-like without no human feeling. Also, improved accuracy. ChatGPT can provide you with accurate and consistent responses to customer inquiries, reducing the likelihood of mistakes or misunderstanding. And this can help to improve the overall customer experience and also help you build trust with your customers. Let me give you an example. For example, I wrote here that a social media manager for a clothing brand could set up a chatbot to respond to questions about product sizing and availability. So if people are always asking about their size and availability, you already know the keywords that they would always use. So you set your chatbot in a way that you put those keywords in ChatGPT, generate the responses, then bring it back into your chatbot and set it so that once people mention that particular keyword, like maybe sizes or colors, it sends them an automatic response. But you've also personalized it. So ChatGPT has helped you save time, meaning you don't have to be in the DMs at every single time. Two is content creation. Now, ChatGPT can help you with content creation by generating new ideas, new headlines, new hooks, and even full blog posts. It can help you write newsletter, but then you need to know how to use it. So when it comes to content creation with ChatGPT, I'm going to give you five things that you can use. Number one, you can use it to generate captions for your social media posts. Like ChatGPT can create generates catchy and engaging captions based on the specific keywords that you've instructed it to create. Number two, content ideation. Like, okay, you don't know what to post. ChatGPT can suggest new content ideas for you. Number three, responding to frequently asked questions. Like I said, ChatGPT, you can list out the frequently asked questions that people ask the brand you're managing or even you, and ChatGPT can generate responses for you. Number four, hashtag suggestions. A lot of people are sleeping on it. ChatGPT can literally help you generate hashtags for every particular post, depending on your caption, depending on the keyword you instruct it with. Also, writing blog posts or articles. Social media managers can use ChatGPT to write blog posts or articles on specific topics related to the industry that you're managing. Like, a lot of people are sleeping on ChatGPT. I'm sure you're there, you're wondering, oh my God, I've been sleeping on ChatGPT. Like, I'm here to awaken you. I'm going to say, okay, it's time for you to wake up, Balaji. It's time for you to wake up. All right. Now, before I go on, if you're still here, please and please don't forget to subscribe. Like this video. Subscribe, like this video. Leave a meaningful comment. Tell me, Balaji, you're doing great. I love to hear that I'm doing great. And if you're listening to me on any of the podcast platforms, don't forget to follow. Don't forget to rate this podcast. Rate it 5-star because, of course, you're learning. Okay. Now, let's go to number three. Social media management. Like, another way social media managers can use ChatGPT is for social media management. You can use this to schedule your posts and measure your performance, and it will give you a better understanding of what's working and what isn't. And it also allows you to make data-driven decisions. And what exactly does this thing involve? We talked about automated customer support with chatbots. I already talked about that at the beginning of this video. We talked about content scheduling and curation. Now, for example, everything you have in ChatGPT, when you're asking it to generate content ideas for you, it's called content curation because it's picking different sources from everywhere on the internet and creating, giving you that response. It's curating every single thing it's searching for based on the question that you asked it, and it is curating those things for you. That's what ChatGPT does. Social listening. Now, I wrote here that ChatGPT can be used for social listening by monitoring your mentions and conversations about your brand on social media, and it can help you stay on top of your brand's reputation and respond to negative comment or feedbacks. Like, you can literally put in the handle of your brand in ChatGPT, and you can ask it to create like a social listening report on so and so brand, and ChatGPT is going to analyze every single thing you need to know about your brand. So you can use it to analyze and also monitor your mentions and every single thing when it comes to social listening. Analytics and reports. ChatGPT can help you generate reports and help you analyze data from your social media accounts. You just need to instruct it to do these things. And you can use this tool to track your engagement, your audience growth, and other important metrics to optimize your social media strategy. Also, influencer outreach. You can put in the handle of the brand you're managing, and you can ask ChatGPT to identify potential influencers that you can collaborate with within a certain region that you're in, or based on the people that your followers are following. ChatGPT can help you to analyze this metrics. Overall, ChatGPT helps social media managers to save time, improve the efficiency of their social media management tasks. Like, if you're not using ChatGPT today, I feel like you're sleeping on it. Like, you literally are sleeping on it, and you need to get up and start using it from today. Number four, and the last part of how you can use ChatGPT as a social media manager, is customer service and community management. Like, you can use it to respond to customer inquiries, resolve customer issues, and even provide product recommendations. And this will help you provide a better customer experience and improve your overall customer satisfaction as a social media manager. You can identify the common customer inquiries and complaints. You can create response templates with ChatGPT. You can train ChatGPT to generate accurate responses that you need. And you can integrate ChatGPT with your social media channels. So, like, once you've created response templates and you've trained ChatGPT, you can integrate it with your social media channels. And this will allow ChatGPT to automatically respond to, like, customers' inquiries and complaints on your behalf. Like, trust me. The possibilities are limitless, but I think you have to be using Pro to achieve most of these features. Also, you can monitor and adjust when it comes to, like, social listening. That's one of the ways you can manage your community, and you can effectively do community management when it comes to using ChatGPT as a social media manager. Like, there are so many ways social media managers can start using ChatGPT today to, like, save time and also improve their workflow. And while you're looking at whether you're looking to automate your responses, generate new ideas, or measure your performance, ChatGPT definitely has you covered. Like, I have been using ChatGPT for myself, for my clients, and trust me, you would definitely not know I'm using ChatGPT because I have been able to, like, master the art of using ChatGPT. You need to play around with it. You need to know how to instruct ChatGPT to be able to use it, because trust me, there are a lot of people that use ChatGPT today as social media managers that when they use it and I see it, I know that they are definitely using ChatGPT. You don't want to be that kind of person that just copies and pastes directly from ChatGPT. You need to know how to personalize. That's when I talked about getting the responses from ChatGPT. Maybe you've imputed your frequently asked questions. I literally noticed something. Sorry to cut you guys short. Sorry to cut in. Like, say this story. I noticed that I stammer a lot. No, I don't stammer. I stutter a lot. So when I stutter, I'm not even going to cut it out because it's something I just noticed recently as I started growing up that, you know what, Balaji, you stutter and that's okay. So I stutter a lot. So yeah, I'm not going to, like, cut that part and everything because then it makes my video look really tacky. So yeah, I stutter a lot, so you should get used to it. All right, so I'm trying to, like, process what I'm about to say or what I'm trying to say. That's why I stutter. So you don't want to copy and paste directly from ChatGPT without customizing. A lot of people, trust me, if you copy and paste from ChatGPT for me, I would know, because I have used ChatGPT to the point that if you don't rewrite and you don't personalize your output or the output that ChatGPT has given you, I would know that you use ChatGPT. So you want to make sure that you take this into consideration when you are instructing ChatGPT. That's it for today. If you like this video, I was trying to, like, check if I missed out on anything. That's it for today, guys. If you've not tried ChatGPT, you should try it. These are four ways that you can use ChatGPT as a social media manager. You know, I don't beat around the bush. I don't give you fluff videos. I go straight to the point, break it down for you. You should check how you can use ChatGPT to create content, to schedule for scheduling and content curation, scheduling, automated responses, and make sure you personalize them, and also for community management, social listening, and a whole lot of others that I mentioned. All right, guys, please don't forget to like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.